get back at it. I got one run done. Got two more to do for the top, and then we'll start on the sides and have to bury this in to prevent anything from trying to dig under and get into the chickens while they're on the run. So, making good progress though. This side, and then we'll run one in the center and connect the two with some wire. Alright, so we got the top of the chicken run covered with wire. Christy's going back and trimming up some of the leftovers, and I'm starting to dig on the trench on the sides. So I'm going to dig a small little trench, bury the chicken wire in, you know, 6 inches or so, and come out 18 inches or so, just to prevent anything trying to dig up under the coop to get to the chickens.
I ain't cut out for all this manual labor crap. Look at the blisters on my hands.
Alright, got one side of the trench done.
Maybe one side, there's more?
Yeah, in the front.
Staple bed.
It is smoldering out here. I guess it's the first day it's gotten to 90 this year.
Okay, so we are almost done with the run. We have just a couple more areas to put the chicken wire in and fill it with dirt so nothing can get under there. No critters, dogs, whatever. Got dirt all over my face. Oh well.
Hi guys, so we're wrapping up for the day. I did not get nowhere near as much done as we wanted to, but that's okay. We got tomorrow to work on that, so we'll have a link to part one of the chicken coop and run build at the end of this video. And yeah, we got the cross braces up on the run, ran all the wire. What else we do?
Dug a trench to bury the wire.
Yeah, we drug.
Covered it back up.
That's about it, actually.
It was hot. It was so hot outside. It was like 100 degrees.
Oh, it was like 90 degrees.
Real Fuel said 99. That's like 100.
Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it.
Bye.
Bye.